Hi again, it's me. Hope everyone is doing well and good and eating. I'm eating, what are they called in English? Pork chops, I think they're called. Yeah, they're called pork chops, okay. So, I'm gonna be having this with some fried tempura, fried sweet potato, and fried noodles.
Really loved it. I really felt like the first.
notes, but you wouldn't see the Duke anymore, so I was kind of like, ah, what the heck? Where is he? I mean, still, it was really good. I have honestly seen before season 3 even came out. Like, this is when season 2 was released. I keep seeing clips from season 2. So I was like, this kind of looks like an interesting show. But it wasn't so interesting. It must have been interesting, but it wasn't like I saw it, but it was more like, nah, I don't think I want to watch it. It still hasn't convinced me. But then this third season, it did convince me. It convinced me so much that I actually watched all of the way through. I didn't just go to season 3. I literally started from the beginning of season 1 all the way to season 3. Now, shocker though, I thought for some reason there was going to be more than 4 episodes. I should have checked first if there was going to be more than 4 episodes, because I was literally like seeing how it was already going to their love already, like right being acknowledgeable, and I was like, hey, what the heck, why is this going a little bit fast? Until like, I think in the last episode it shows like a trailer or a teaser of what's going to come next, and I was like, sucks though. I wish they would have just put it all together. I wonder if that's gonna be like the finale, or are they just gonna like wait for all the Bridgerton siblings to get coupled up and call it a finale and that's it. Which I think that's kind of like okay, I guess. Well, actually, I kept saying that for the first season two, and then the second season surprised me, and then for the third season surprised me as well. So I can't be saying like, You know what, though? What I did feel they did a little too fast was reveal who Lady Whistledown was. I feel like they did that too fast. I feel like it would have been nice to have let the audience see who it is. So people could have been like, oh, I think I know who it is and all this stuff. Would have been nice. But I mean, I guess to each their own. I mean, that's their show. That's their writing. So that's their stuff they could decide. What other show I've been watching? I've been watching Sex in the City.
It's just something that came up in my mind. I don't know.
would say you have to go to the doctor's appointment. You're obviously not going to tell your mom or your dad or your uncles and aunts to go with you to the doctor's appointment. You're going to ask your significant other because your significant other is the one that's going to be there with you. Literally, like if you're going through some sort of injury, pain, pregnancy, your partner has to be there with you, you know? So it's kind of like, it sort of does become a we thing because it's both of you guys. You have to be there for one another. That other person has to be your priority, you know? And their plans somehow become your plans and your plans become their plans because you're now sharing a life together, which is a pretty interesting topic to pick at. I mean, people could have different opinions on it, but yeah, that's how I see it. Well, another show I've been watching is the only difference is that Kuroko comes from a very good basketball team, and he's trying to show that the way that he plays basketball is a good basketball method, like as in a way trying to show that success rather than being alone. I'm patching it up like in the how it ends. And then throughout the show he's just playing against other schools and he's playing against his team members' school. His former members.
This man Mm-hmm.